People are here. And so, what happened to you last night?
The pain went last night, but as I was driving home, I had a really bad pain across my lower back.
Yeah.
I did what you said, rebuked it, in the name of Jesus, and went.
Isn't it amazing?
Yeah.
This is so important. There's many Christians who still live under all sorts of diseases and oppression. They don't understand their authority in Jesus. And they're, you know what? You can actually come under something. And this whole congregation, if you don't understand this, they come under sickness, disease, and depression. They don't know they have authority. And last night I was teaching about this. Don't let the enemy rob from you. And maybe you got healed 10 years ago. Oh, I got healed back in 75. Oh, I got healed back in 92. It all came back on me. Well, one time I was free from depression, and all the depression's come back to me. You have authority in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
So how dare you, devil, take me back off my life? Yeah. And so how long was the pain there for?
Only about 10 minutes.
But the pain before?
Well, I've had pain for probably the last 30 years.
Sure, okay.
Hmm. Yep.
And so what happened to your neck last night?
All the pain went out of my neck.
Yeah.
It's probably about 70-80% this morning.
Okay. Now this is so important. Now, this is something else I've found. Sometimes people have so much pain in an area that when I pray, and when the person gets great relief, they're so excited about the great relief, later on they find out they still have a residue of pain. And I always encourage people to come back. And so you still have about 20-30% pain left.
Yeah.
And I wonder, Tim, how bad was the pain normally?
It got to the stage where it was causing depression. Especially by the end of the day, I just wished my life had ended. It was that bad.
So how's your feeling now after prayer last night?
Like, it's good today.
So you're feeling a little bit left there?
Yeah, a little bit.
Now, this is so important. His comeback. You know, some people get prayer, they improve, and they don't come back. And they think, oh, well, it's improved, so I'm happy with the improvement. Who wants improvement? We're after 100%.
Amen.
Come on. You know what? Faith is like this. How far do you want to go with this deal? How far do you want to go with faith? If you need a bit more prayer, push in for some more. Push in for some more. Don't settle for second best or third best or fourth best. And just, can we pray again for you?
Yeah.
Can we pray that the last little bit that goes on his neck? Yeah. Let's reach out to him. And we just pray the last bit to go from this man's neck right now, and it'll never, ever come back to him ever again. The last little bit to go. Now in Jesus' name, let it never come back as long as he ever lives in Jesus' name. More. See, it's very simple. The Bible says believers can lay hands on the sick. And you know, there's many ways that God heals, but one way, I just lay my hands on the sick body. And the Bible says I have an anointing, Christ lives in me, and by faith, we can release healing. And one of the ways we release healing is by our words. I speak the sickness. I command to leave. I command body parts to be healed, organs to be healed. And Lord, let this neck be healed now. Just move it down. How's that?
Yeah, that's good.
Gone now?
Yeah.
Now, if it ever tries to sneak back, lock it back, put your hand there and go straight away. God bless you. Give him a hand, everybody.